fighting, driving, running and gliding, jumping on trains to jumping on planes. Welcome to the hype of What Is Saints Row, filled with jokes and awkward moments and a big free roam map. With limitless possibilities, what could go wrong? My name is Seb and welcome to Jump Inside Games. Hi, this video is part of a review segment on our channel. Our reviews are based on what we feel about what we want to experience within the first 2 hours of a video game. Is it worth playing? Well, we have a score system that will determine that. Also, we much appreciate your comments, so if you've played this game, please mention what you feel about this game in the comments below. Let's begin with our character. Also, I'm not showing you the introduction to this game, as there is a slight spoiler at the start. We are part of this assault group, and yes, we are a completely new character compared to the previous games in this series. A brand new beginning. Your team gets exploded, and you have the objective to regroup and fight through the enemy. This is part of the tutorial for the game, and it's updated and smoother than previous games in this series, which feels the same but better. In fact, this whole game just feels like an improvement. So, start shooting and head to your objective. So far, I'm getting a little bit of the Saints Row comedy, but not over the top.
But next time I give an order, the only words I want to hear are yes and ma'am. Got that?
Yes ma'am.
In fact, I feel like they're dipping into all the best bits of the previous Saints Row games. Anyway, let's meet our CO, Commanding Officer, who we don't get along with. But hey, we get paid, right?
Stand down! We don't got time for hero bullshit!
After a time, welcome to the new city. We get to explore, meet our friends. We need money, so we need to pay that rent.
So, is this how it's gonna be every time we have to pay rent?
I thought that went great.
So, this game is already introducing us to what feels like a rags-to-riches story. One of the main features of this game is the phone, and on it you can style your character to whatever you want he or she to look like. You don't need to visit a store to do it. If you want to change your character at any point, just go and point and click on your phone, select style, and boom. Change your character to just the way you like it.
The only way this could be better is if you put on a fucking shirt.
One of the more interesting and well done things in this game for me was the car jumping ability. It's done to a point that you need to be in a car, go on a roof, and then glide. This is much better than the super glide you get in Saints Row 4 that lets you just jump and glide at any point to anywhere, which makes the cars in Saints Row 4 kind of obsolete.
I saw a better way and I took it.
I think with everything I've seen and experienced in this game, I will say it all comes down to not being serious. Unlike other free roam games, you are in an open world. From jumping trains to shooting miniguns, driving and gliding, to jumping on aircrafts, this game can probably be defined in 6 words. It's all about having a blast. Now let's break it down to the final scores.
Oh god!
Starting off with pricing. With the first 2 hours of this game, with the experience of what I have experienced so far, the pricing of this game is expensive, but I think it's worth it for the content you're gonna get out of this game. In fact, if you want an open world exploration game where you want a story but you also just want to mess around without taking it too seriously, then this game is right up your alley for video games. The Gold Edition, for me, I didn't get. But it just seemed a little bit high on the pricey side of things. And for the Platinum, you're getting Saints Row the Third Remastered on top of it. But that's quite pricey. So for me, that is a total of 8 out of 10. Next, gameplay. And this is exceptionally good. With all the stuff you can do in this game, and I've only experienced less than 4 hours of this game gets a solid 10 out of 10. Next, the story. It's a Saints Row game, it's more focused on gameplay than story, but I have to say, the story feels more simpler to understand than previous Saints Row the Third. Though, Saints Row isn't a major story game, usually it's more of a gang-based shooter takeover game, formatted into a story. That's why I'm giving this a 7 out of 10. And finally, the graphics. Now, I've only got an Xbox Series X to experience this game on, and beyond me, If this is the way graphics are getting in video games, then this game takes the cake. This game may not be the most realistic game in the world, but it looks so smooth. You're watching this as a rendered YouTube video, but this game, of what I'm watching, it looks super crispy, and I'm giving it a solid 10 out of 10.
Can Antonio and I count on you or not?
Yes, sir.
Overall, this game gets a solid 35 out of 40, which is a solid 9 out of 10. And that right there is a jump inside recommendation. So if you're looking in for a mess around game and having fun, then have a go at Saints Row. Anyway, catch you later and goodbye.